Hello children, once again welcome back you to the online session. So we have seen the, now what is the topics we are seeing? That is the properties of materials. So what are all the properties? Tell me one by one, what is the first property? Yes, tell me louder. Yes, what is it? Appearance. The second one is hardness. And the third, what is the third one? Soluble or insoluble. And then float and sink. Why do objects float and sink in water? In that, now what we are going to see is buoyant force. What is that buoyant force? Ability of an object to float is called as buoyant force. Ability of an object to float. See, you are able to see a ship which is sailing on water. So whether it is floating or whether the object sinks here, yes, it floats. Okay, I have already given you a question. What is that? Why do an ship floats in water, but why an iron nail sinks? Many of you had given the correct answer. Very good, children. So, because due to the density of the iron nail is higher. So, this theory is related to the Archimedes principle. What is it? Archimedes principle. Look at here, the ability to float is called as buoyant force and is called as buoyancy. So what is that Archimedes principle? I said you write that story, Eureka, Eureka. So I'll tell you the principle alone once. So when an object is immersed in a water, the density of water which comes out is equal to the density of the object which is immersed inside it. Now you are able to see here. See? So an object is immersed in a water. So when this object gets into it, what happens to the water? It flows out. The water flows out. So the density of water which flows out and the density of that material is equal. This is called as Archimedes principle. Shall we go to the next one? Okay, what is the next one? Types of materials. So what are all the types of materials? Tell me one by one. Very good. So transparent materials, translucent material and then opaque material. What is it? Transparent, translucent and opaque. Whether you are taking hints or not, children? Okay, what is the first one? It is transparency. What do you mean by transparency? So the light passes through the material. The materials which allow the light to pass through it is called as transparency. Examples are, look at here. So by being on the one side, we are able to see the other side of the material or the surroundings which is there. So while taking a glass, by being on the one side, we are able to see the other side. So glass is an example of transparent material. So it allows all the light to pass through itself. So I hope in the 6th standard you will have studied about the properties of light. Yes, now you are studying 6th, right? I have taught you, right? In light, shadow and reflection lesson. Yes or no, children? In light, shadow and reflection lesson, I have taught you about the properties of light. What is that? Transparency and then what are the other properties? Dispersion, yes, scattering, polarization and then what is it? Yes, and then diffraction, reflection. So these are all the properties of materials. So here when a light passes through the material, so this material absorbs all the light and reflects, it gives it on the other side. So this type of materials are called as transparent materials. The second one is translucent. So what is this translucent? These materials allow some or little light to pass through it. It does not allow all the light to pass through it. Few light rays are reflected from its surface. So this type of materials are called as translucent materials. So what is this? These are all some of the examples of translucent material. What is it? Sunglasses and then soda bottles. So whether being on the one side, we are able to see the other side clearly, children? No. So the image will be diminished. We are not able to get a clear image. And then what is the next property? Opaque. What do you mean by opaque? Yes. These materials do not allow any light to pass through it. These materials do not allow any light to pass through it are called as opaque materials. So examples are what? Wood. Yes or no? Wood, tire. These are all opaque material. They do not absorb any light at all. So this image explains you about the light passing through a material. So what is this? Consider this as a transparent material. This is a translucent and this as a opaque material. So we are sending a beam of light through it. So what happens in transparent? It absorbs all the light and gives it on the other side. See here. So but in translucent it absorbs only some light. Whereas in the case of opaque, it do not allow any light to pass through it. Look at this image. So if it is a transparent, we are able to get a clear image. In case of translucent, the image is diminished. And whereas in the case of opaque, we are not able to see anything which is on the other side. Okay. Now shall we go for a discussing question and answers? Okay, look at here. In the last class, we have seen only these first three options. So we have stopped here, right? Now we will continue with this. Find odd one out from the following. You know, right, what is mean by odd one out, which is not related to it. So now we will go with that, okay? So see here, stone, bed, cup, boy, wooden box. So, which is the odd one in this first statement? Yes, very good. It is boy. Because stone, bed, cup, wooden box, everything are non-living things. Whereas boy is a living thing. And then look at the option B. Mango, cherry, rose, grapes and apple. So, which is the odd one here? Yes, good. So, the option is rose. Because mango, cherry, grapes and apple is a what? Fruit. Rose is a flower. And then gold, soil, aluminium, silver, platinum and iron. Which is the odd one here? I want everyone to answer to this question. Yes, the option is soil. Very good. Because gold, aluminium, silver, platinum, iron, everything are metal. But soil is not a metal. Coming to the last one, look at here. Sugar, salt, ink, lemon juice, milk and wood. Here, which is the odd one? Yes, can you tell me? Yes. Yeah, so the option is answer is wood, because we are able to dissolve all this in water. Yes or no? Ink gets dissolved in water, salt, sugar, lemon juice and milk, everything we are able to dissolve in water, but wood, it does not dissolve in water. Shall we go to the next question? Look at here. Sam founds a bag containing the following materials. So what are all the materials? Mirror, paper stained with oil, wood, glass, spectacles. So in this, which is our opaque materials? Among these following materials, which is a opaque material? So what is this? Mirror. Whether mirror is opaque? Paper stained with oil, wood, glass, spectacles. So whether wood is a opaque material or not, children? Yes, wood is a opaque material. So it does not allow any light to pass through it. Glass spectacles? No. It is a translucent material. sunglasses. If it is a sunglass, it is a translucent. If it is a glass, it is a transparent material. So this is not an opaque material. And in the case of mirror, we are able to see only our image. We are not able to see the other side of the mirror. Yes or no? So mirror is also a opaque material. And then paper stained with oil. So paper is an opaque material. So if we coat or apply oil on it, it becomes translucent material. When we apply oil in a sheet of paper, that paper becomes a translucent material. So the correct option is option 1 and 3. Which is the correct option? Option 1 and 3. Shall we go to the next question? Look at here. Pick one material from the following which is completely soluble in water. What is the question here? Which is completely soluble in water. Look at the first one. What is it? Chalk powder, tea leaves, glucose, sawdust. Whether chalk powder is completely soluble in water? No. So it does not get completely dissolved in water. Tea leaves? No. Glucose, whether it gets dissolved in water? Yes. Sawdust? No. Sawdust does not dissolve in water. So the correct answer is option C. So look at the next question. Which one of the following is insoluble in water? What is the question? Which is insoluble in water? What is this first one? Alcohol. Alcohol is soluble in water. Yes or no? Yes. And then option B, sodium chloride. Yes. Sodium chloride is a chemical which is completely soluble in water. And sugar. Yes. Sugar also gets dissolved in water. But coconut oil, due to its density difference, the density of what coconut oil is higher than the density of water. So coconut oil does not dissolve in water. Look at here, children. This is the last question for you. Match the objects given below with the materials from which they could be made. Remember, an object could be made from more than one material, and given materials could be used for making many objects. Okay, so what is the first one? You have to make match it objects with the material. So books are made with the help of glass, wood, paper, leather, plastic. What is the correct answer? Yes, books are made with the help of paper. And then tumbler. Yes, it can be made with the help of glass. It can be made with the help of plastic also. So we'll see the next one. Sorry. Chair. Yes, chair can be made with the help of wood. And then toys. Toys are made with plastics. Then shoes are made with leather. So tumblers are made with glass. So these are all the correct options. Book, paper, tumbler, glass, chair, wood, toy, plastic, shoes, leather. So look at here, you have one more question also. Which pair of substance float in water? I think I would have given this question already to you. Okay. Which pair of substance float in water? Pin, oil drops. No. Pin sinks, oil drops floats. Coin sinks, rubber band floats. Yes. Iron nail sinks, cotton thread floats. I want the two substances also to float on water. So what is the answer? Option C, that is plastic ball and feather, floats on the surface of water. So children, I thank you all for listening the class patiently. Go through the lesson completely. If you have any doubts, clarify your doubts with me, okay? So thank you all. Have a nice day.